Hey guys, JP Fluellen here. I'm going to tell you my story tonight. And I know a lot of YouTubers out there, you don't really know who they really are. They're not telling you the real story. And so tonight you're going to get the real JP Fluellen. So I grew up in a trailer back in the late 80s and didn't get into my first real home until the end of the 80s. Just kind of was always wondering, like, what would life be like if I had a normal life and had, you know, my parents were great, but they weren't really entrepreneurs. They were just, you know, you get a degree, you go to work, you work hard, and you just live life, and you just go through the rat race, and you just kind of do the thing. My dad was military. He got out of the military in 1986, and I was 9 years old. When he got out, and you know, he was definitely he struggled post military, and just couldn't really get his niche and get reassimilated back into the working world. And I just saw how my parents worked paycheck to paycheck. I saw how my dad struggled financially as being the breadwinner of the house outside of the military, and I saw how much stress it put on my mom, having to carry the burden of the breadwinner of our family. And you know, I personally, you know, I saw this early on, and I felt like it put a huge toll on me in terms of just how unstable or inconsistent you know, paychecks were. Because a lot of the jobs that my mom had to do were pretty stressful on her, and put a lot of you know, pressure on her to bring home income. And as my dad jumped from job to job, I think over the course of the latter 20 year plus years after my dad retired from the military, he just never really got that one job or that one chance to really lock in a consistent income. And so for me, you know, I saw my parents going through this cycle of working and just realized that there had to be a better way. And so when I learned about commissioned sales, that was when it really was kind of this turning point for me, because it was really hard for me to work a regular job for a little to nothing hourly wage. And to me, it felt like an insult on my value. And so as I was pursuing whatever my career was supposed to be, you know, I met my high school sweetheart, I fell in love and asked her to marry me. And she said, let me think about it. So that was awesome. And, but during that process, you know, I was also the oldest of two boys. So it was just me and my brother, and I was the oldest. So my parents kind of, I was the trial child, and there was a trial for everything. It was the trial of, oh, how do we put our kid in college? Oh, well, we'll just have to save up. Oh, well, if he wants to get college paid for, he's going to have to join the military. And so there was all these little things that, you know, I was hoping were going to be fruitful. And it's just, we didn't know what we were doing. We didn't know how to do it fast enough. And so therefore, there was a lot of failure in terms of that kind of stuff. So so I went to college for 3 months. After about 2 years of not wanting to go to college. And, you know, when I got engaged, or rather asked my wife to marry me, and I was challenged with, how are you going to provide for my daughter? And I knew in my heart of hearts that college was not for me. However, I made the attempt to go to college because I respected her dad. And so I made that attempt. And after 7 years of trial and error, I still have today yet to get my 4-year degree. And so my answer to the degree issue was I had went to college for 2 years at an applied science college. And for those of you that have an Associates of Applied Sciences, that's the equivalent to a certificate of on-the-job training, which is not going to get you very far in life. So anyways, so moving along there, I knew that commission sales was my thing. And I had done a ton of jobs. I had done cellular phone. I did business to business. I did all these kind of sales. And I knew that the harder you worked, the more you're worth, which is not what a regular job does. A regular job is the harder you work, you just need to fill in those 8 hours. So go ahead and fill in those 8 hours because you're not going to be worth any more than those 8 hours. So, so as a result of that, I moved into other commission sales jobs. So I did cellular phones, I sold shoes, I sold long distance, I did telemarketing for 2.5 years, I did car sales, I did door-to-door sales, and as a matter of fact, I actually got more opportunities later on doing door-to-door sales by those skills than I had any college education on planet Earth. So for those of you that have done door-to-door sales, you know what I'm talking about. Like, it is high pressure, high motivation. You have to be very self-motivated in order to do door-to-door sales. And when you put that on a resume, it actually opens up way more opportunities than I would say any college degree out there. Now, don't get me wrong, college degrees are necessary. I think in specialized fields, like if you're going to be physical therapist, doctor, attorney, but you know, I think that sociology, psychology, criminal justice, all these four-year degrees are pretty much just throwaway degrees. It's just, you go to college because your parents either had set aside money for college, or you just were basically, you know, programmed that that was the way for you to go. So, you know, it's not for everybody. However, I think for me and for a lot of people, like, what is the ultimate goal? Like, you graduate high school and you want to make money, right? So I found real estate by accident. I was actually working as a rental car attendant, and in that job, sales was more of achievement rather than actual extra cash. However, it was a job that required a four-year degree that I got because I had door-to-door sales experience. So that's how I got that job. So that really got me super stoked about, like, what's the next stage of life, right? So I did that for 2.5 years up until 2010. I was presented the opportunity to think about getting my real estate license. And I got my real estate license, even though, like, as I just said, I was not good at school, you know, because those that go to school for 7 years, they're called doctors. However, that was just not my jam. It just didn't work for me. And I really, really had this thing that in my mind that said, you know, what is next for me? And, you know, and so I took a leap of faith and jumped in, got a real estate license in 2010. And, I hit flatlined for 6 months. I was like, I don't know how to get customers. I don't know how to acquire leads. I don't know how to make phone calls. I don't know how to do any of this stuff because I was not trained on any of this stuff. And so I was presented this opportunity, come work for my brokerage. And, you know, and I got signed up, and it just was not what was sold, essentially. And so I figured out how to acquire a customer. I figured out how to do the script training, how to close the deals, how to goal set and business plan and all these things. And I learned this over the course of the next 3 years. And real estate is probably the most rewarding job once you understand the roadmap and the equation of success. And once you've been able to learn that equation for success, it's just a math problem. It's this amount of effort equals this amount of leads equals this amount of conversations, which equals this amount of closings. And when you realize that the amount of effort you put into this business is directly proportionate, or probably even in proportionate to the amount of money that you make. So, you know, if you're listening to this and you've been inspired and you want to learn how to make a lot of money and want to know what that equation for success is, please reach out to us. Just hit me a DM, or just make a comment in the YouTube comments. Shoot me a text. My number is 307-772-1184. If this has resonated with you at all and you want to know what's going on with me over at the Titan Real Estate team, and give us a call. And if you want to hear more content about what we're doing and you like what you're hearing, just go ahead and smash that subscribe button, hit that alert, and we'll be happy to share with you some more of our secrets to a plentiful and exciting real estate career. Have a great day.